Liberty begins the 2019-20 season with a hard-fought 66-60 victory over Radford. It was a game they looked like they had in hand, but wouldn't you know it, the Highlanders made this one difficult down the stretch, just like we expected.
Yeah, you know, the start maybe surprised us a little bit. I think Liberty had the advantage of being home.
Yeah.
So some of those early shots fell, and they jumped out to that lead. But, yeah, we'd expect nothing else but a hard-fought game that went down two possessions.
Boy, I didn't expect the freshmen to play the role they did for the Flames early on, especially Kyle Roach, Al Robinson, each with seven apiece in the first half.
Yeah, we were waiting for the veterans to kind of step up, but those guys sensed they fit in, and they blended in and were confident, took shots when they had them and made them.
Second half, though, it was the Carly Jones show. He had a career-high 31 in this ball game as he put Radford on his back and tried to bring him back in this one.
Yeah, scored every way possible, inside, out, mid-range. Liberty really had no answer for him. The help wasn't there.
And then in crunch time, the Flames looking to their senior leaders, Caleb Holmesley and Miles Baxter Bell as well, coming off the bench.
Yeah, Caleb hit some big shots or got himself to the free throw line, 9 free throws. Mayo, big hustle play, great heads-up play for the putback, and that was a wrap.
That's right. Liberty led by as many as 20, ended up hanging on to win by 6 as we take a look at the final stats. What jumps out to you, Ness?
Well, you know, the bench points, again, so, yeah. We talk about the depth. The freshman got in early, got in and contributed early. Liberty's assists, you know, that's a little deceiving. They had 11 of them in the first half when things were really flowing. It stagnated a little bit, but credit Radford. I mean, aside from Carleek, they got the 10 offensive rebounds to give themselves some extra possessions and keep them in this game.
One concern if you're Liberty, one coaching point for Coach McKay, yeah, that offense kind of got stagnant in the second half and struggled a bit.
Yeah, the offense was a little stagnant, and the pack line, even with those veterans, guys that have played it all the time, they got to clean that up. The help defense was not there.
Yeah, Carleek Jones was getting to the rim almost at will.
Yeah.
The Flames fortunate to come away with win number one. They knew it was going to be tough. It certainly was. They'll take that 66-60 victory, and now look ahead to Sunday when they will host Maryland Eastern Shore right here in the Vine Center at 2 o'clock.